and learners, welcome to Code to Link. In today's session, I'm going to talk about some amazing ways of giving a very unique look to the forms that we create using Microsoft Forms or Google Forms. I'm going to talk about how to create designer pictures for your question. This session is, as it is, will be very interesting for all the teachers, but especially it will be very helpful for teachers who teach math and chemistry. So let's get started. This is a form that I have here for you, and what I want to show you is this question that I have put up here. I have inserted a picture of this kind. Now, this picture is not what I have got, a ready-made picture. It's my own creation. And that's what I'm going to talk to you about, how to create a picture of your own to insert in a question. Now, how to insert a picture in a question, the video of that I have created, you will find the link of it here somewhere. Also, I have put it up in the description box, so you can check out there and see how we can go about doing that. But right now, let's focus on how to create a personalized picture for our question. For this, I have just used very simple tools like a word file, some insert option, inserting shapes, and a snipping tool. So we go to insert, shapes, and suppose I select this particular shape and I drag it here. Okay, I type something in it like, say, code to link. I select that text, make it bigger and bold, and there I'm ready. This is what I want to insert as a picture in my question. So how do I go about converting a shape into a picture? Well, for that, you need to click the Windows icon and Windows button, and you can just type out snipping tool, and this is the kind of tool that's available in Windows. You will find it in your computer, and you can go for that particular app which will help you convert a shape into a picture. So here I have a snipping tool. When you click on it, you get this kind of a dialog box. Click on new, you will have various options available there: free form, rectangular, window snip, full screen snip. Right now, I'll go for the rectangular snip. Moment I click on it, you see the mouse pointer has turned into a plus sign. Well, let me just drag it and click that much part of the shape. And there it is. I am getting that part as a picture, separate picture. So basically, it works like a pair of scissors. And then you can click on copy and copy that image and paste it somewhere in a Word file or directly into your presentation if you want to. But right now I want to save it as a picture because I want to use it as a picture. So there I go, I save it as Capture 9 and save, okay, and close this particular snip. Then I go to Forms and let me show you how I did this. Okay, so I add new choice. Okay, I go here, add image, upload, and I say Capture 9, open. That particular image is uploading here. And in the meantime, I can type out which. Okay, there the image has already come. You see the image is quite large. I can type out the question here, which channel and things like that. I can type out over there everything, my question. There is the picture. If I feel the picture is too large, no, I don't want it that way, well, I can go for the small option, and this is how it would appear. Here will be my question type out, here will be the picture, and down there I can give the options. Okay, so that's one way I can insert a picture, making it more creative. Now, the science teachers, the physics teacher, if you want to ask a circuit, then the chemistry teacher can write down in Word file the equation, like, say, okay, I'll just insert another shape here, and say this time I would go for an ellipse. Okay, let's go for it. And I type here, say, CH3 plus H2O. Okay, let me make it bigger and bold. And what I do is I just now have to select 3 and subscript it, select 2 and subscript it, and I'm ready. I have H2O. Let me go for the snip. I will say rectangular snip. I will snip this particular picture, save it, say capture 10, okay, enter, close this, go to forms again, and here I can insert that particular picture. Okay, let me just do it. Okay, let me click on a new, add new. I'll show you. I can insert here image and upload, and I go for H2O thing, and there it will upload as an image. So chemistry teachers, now the math teachers, we don't have the option of typing out square root, integration sign, derivation sign and things like that. So for them, it is very useful. You can type out in Word their entire math sum that you want to put up, and then you can snip it. You can even give a nice background color to your text box, and you can upload it here as a question. So, and if the physics teacher or a digital electronics teacher like me would like to upload, say, a circuit, then I can draw a circuit, snip it, save, and upload the image. Very easy and very interesting way of doing it, right? The next that I want to show you, one of my creations which I like, is this kind. Here what I have done is I have uploaded the question in a nested format. I have used two different kinds of text boxes and two different colors, one nested into the other. So that gave a nesting kind of a look to the picture, and accordingly I have put up the question here, the picture here, and then the options. The another important or interesting way that I have used is this. I have used simply three text boxes here, or three shapes here, and that's the outer one, the gray one. I have written my code over there. Then I have put up the possible outputs into different kind of shapes. The one, the yellow, the other one, the blue one, as you can see here. And then what I did is I gave the user these kind of options. Which one is the correct output for the given code? Is it the yellow block? Is it the blue block? Or is it neither of them? So this is how I went about giving a pinch of, you know, interesting way of putting up the question. That's how I have done it here for this particular question. The next and the most interesting and my favorite creation is this one. What I have done here is I have asked what's the character represented by ASCII value 100, and I have put up three options, option A, B, C, and each one has an answer attached to it. So that's capital C, that's character 2, and then lowercase c. And what I did was I gave as options to the user option A, option B, option C. Now I have also opted for shuffle options in this particular question. If I click on this and I show you here, I have created a separate video for it as well. You can see shuffle options, right? I've tick marked it. So each user will get separate options. They will get CBA, ABC, BCA, any kind, it will shuffle for each user. But that's not an issue because they have to select from here, but the correct answer is actually displayed here. So this is what I just liked creating once. I really enjoyed doing this thing. And these are the various options that I showed you for giving a very personalized and very creative look to your form. Now, just a word of caution that I want to tell you all, that when you load pictures of these kind, make sure the picture is of lesser size, because when you load more pictures into your form, the user will take a wee bit of more time, the form will take a wee bit of more time at the user end to download. So accordingly, if you are a teacher, you give them little more time to download their form totally, fully. And if you are creating a survey or anything of that kind, do make sure that you have enough time limit set for the response, because the form will take a little bit more time to load at the other end. So that's what I wanted to share with you all today. And If you have enjoyed what you have just seen, then do like the channel, do subscribe for it. In the next video, I'm going to talk about how to assign a test or a quiz in Teams. And I'm going to talk about what points to take care of while assigning a test through Teams. Now, this is one important point that I'm going to discuss, because we need to take care of certain things while assigning a test or a quiz to the students through Teams so that we get the responses in the right way that we want to have it. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe for the channel if you like the content that you're watching. Hit the like icon. Put up any queries that you have in the comment section. If you like the creative ways that I've put up right now, do comment for that as well. It will give me inspiration to create more videos. Okay then, happy learning, and I'll see you in the next video.